Disclaimer: this review features a collectible item and it's for adult collectors ages 13 and up only. It is not intended for children. So if you are age 13 or below, please stop watching this video now. Thank you. Lydia here and welcome back to a new action figure review on my channel. So today I have with me a Fortnite action figure from McFarlane Toys, and honestly it's a little bit of a surprise for me too, because I am in no way, shape or form interested in the Fortnite game. And I don't really know anything about it. It's just not my type of game, honestly. And it's one of those, like, shooting, playing against other type of online games, which, again, it's not for me. So, you may ask, why do I have this figure? Well, it's easy. If you took a look at my channel's name, my username or my channel's name, it's Werewolf Lydia. And, as you can see, inside the box, there is a werewolf. And you can probably guess now that I am a huge, and if you already didn't know, of course, I am a huge, huge fan of werewolves, and I love to own a lot of werewolf figures, and if I get a chance to grab any figures that are like werewolves, then I get it. So here I am with this Fortnite figure from McFarlane Toys, which is called Dire, as you can see, or Dire Wolf. But, you know, it's a werewolf. I mean, you can tell from how he looks that he is a super cute modern but super cute and cool looking werewolf. So that's why I have this figure, and I actually got it for Christmas. If you saw my Christmas haul video, you know that I chose this figure because it is a werewolf. So I just thought that I should do a review of it, and first, I'm going to show you guys the box, and after that I will unbox it and show you guys the details of the figure. Again, so just a note, and I mentioned it before, don't know anything about the game, so I don't know what the weapons are or if they have names or whatever. Just keep that in mind. So let's get started. So here is a close-up of the box, and as you can see, the cardboard part is purple. It's actually darker purple than it shows on camera. It's kind of like that. And it says Fortnite, and over here in this yellow dot says that 22 moving parts in different languages. So it's a pretty well articulated figure. And the background inside is blue with some triangles on it. I don't know, maybe it has something to do with the game, I have no idea. And here's the figure inside, and he comes with three type of weapons and also a stand, which I am super happy about, because you know, he has some interesting articulations, and not sure how well he will be able to stand on his own. So yeah, and over here we have this little shiny sticker. It says Fortnite on it, not sure if you can see it. It's kind of, yes, now you can see it. There you go. And it says for years 12 and up. Dire, and over here it says Epic Games. Now on the top we have a nice like CGI graphic for the wolf, and it says McFarlane Toys, Fortnite Dire. And we have the same on the side as well. I think it's on the other, oh no, it's, well, yes, you can see it over here too, but it has this cut out because this is a plastic front. You can actually see it from the side to the figure. And this is the back of the box. Again, it says Fortnite, and we get a full body shot of the figure over here. with another figure. Not sure who that is. Looks kind of like a soldier of some sort. And some of the other figures, by the way, they actually have really, really like cool designs. Some of them are funny, some of them are really cool. I really like this dude over here with that skull head. But yeah, that one looks kind of like a Okami or something. So yeah, some of them have really, really cool designs. It says 7-inch action figures or 17 centimeters. Some info here and there. A glider pack, so this is like a 14 inches. What does it say over here? Figure sold separately. Okay, so you have to buy the figure and the playset separately if you wanted this glider pack. So yeah, pretty nice packaging. And that's about it for the box. Now let me just unbox him and we'll see how cool this figure is. And I'm back and I have unboxed my Direwolf figure here. And he is super cool and super detailed. And really, really like nice quality, nice hard plastic. Which I absolutely love. I do think I have to heat up some parts on him because it's kind of hard to move those parts, so maybe some of the paint is stuck in there, I don't know yet. But he is super duper cool and I really, really love the fact that he comes with a stand, because otherwise he wouldn't be able to stand on his feet due to the how his legs are shaped. And he comes with some, as you saw in the inbox version, he comes with some weapons as well. So first let's take a closer look at the accessories that he comes with, and after that you will be able to see up close of the figure. Okay, so the accessories. He comes with three weapons. The first is this pretty big hammer. Or it's actually like a double weapon. On this side there is this hammer. By the way, you can see that the paint job is really nicely made. I really, really love it. It's nicely painted and detailed. This is how the hammer looks. There is this little strap, which he can't really hold it in his hand, but it still looks good. And on this side there is this crowbar. So yeah, it's like a makeshift double weapon, but I think it looks really cool. The next one is this sword, or maybe it's a katana, I'm not exactly sure. And it's not like, it's just one piece, so you cannot take the sword out of the sword holder thingy. I'm not sure what this is called, I'm not the best when it comes to weapons. And as you can see, it has this little peg here, and that's because you can actually put it on him. There's a hole in the back and you just have to plug it in over there, and that's how he carries this around. So this is more like a decoration weapon than an actual weapon that he can you know, use and whatnot. And the third weapon is this machine gun, or I'm not, again, not exactly sure what type of weapon, but this is how it looks like. And again, really nicely detailed and painted. And by the way, I actually have a hard time placing the weapons in his hands, because the hands are such a hard plastic that you have to really force them to be able to put the weapons in them. So I'm not really, I don't feel comfortable like that, and that's why I don't really force it. And I actually like him better without the weapons. I mean, I like that the katana is on his back, but the other ones, I'm just not really a fan of them. And I mean, they look cool, don't get me wrong, but I just like it how he looks like this, just with, you know, some fists, and it's like he will punch you out or something. So I think I'm going to display him without any of these weapons. But yeah, still pretty cool. And of course the stand. The stand actually has two little pegs over there, and you just put him on there, attach it from his feet. It's a black plastic stand, and it says Fortnite on it. This is how it looks. By the way, it's pretty thick and pretty nice quality plastic, so he has no trouble standing up. Now let's take a closer look at the figure. So here is a close-up of the figure's face, and as you can see, he has a really angry and awesomely sculpted werewolf head, and the whole wolf is actually this dark, a little bit shiny silver color, and he has kind of like a mohawk, and the top of the mohawk, it kind of fades into a lighter gray color, and he actually has that lighter color on his cheeks, or I don't know what to call it, cheek fur. The inside of his ears are red, interesting, and he has red and yellow eyes, as you can see, huge teeth, a big black doggy nose, and he has this red bandana around his head tied in the back in this nice action pose. So he kind of reminds me of a ninja or something like that, or a street fighter or something. Now moving down, he has a nice six-pack over here, and that's actually colored a lighter gray, as you can see. And he is pretty buffed for here in the front, and he is wearing this awesome, I guess this was probably originally like a leather jacket, but the sleeves have been ripped off, so it kind of reminds me of, you know, when a werewolf actually like transforms, a human transforms into a werewolf, and it's black with some white parts on it and some red, some gold details. So yeah, it looks really, some buttons over there, looks really, really cool. This is how it looks in the back, so it's all ripped apart, and that's the little hole that I showed you before, so that you can put the katana in it. And before I move down, I actually wanted to move down, but I remember that he has some gloves, some it's a light brown color on this side, and on this side he has this again, not sure what to call it, like a type of ring, but you can punch with it and that's gold colored. He also has this I don't know, bracelet of some sort that's gold colored. It has some spikes on it, as you can see. Now moving down, he was once wearing probably a long jeans pants, but now they are all ripped up and full with holes, so it's now like a jeans short. Some nice pocket details, nice wrinkles. So again, really, really nicely sculpted. And as you can see, he has a black belt with a gold buckle in the front. The buckle is just simple. I wish it had some kind of design on it, honestly. And over here, he has some nunchucks attached to the belt, but you cannot take this off, so this is part of the mold, actually. And as you can see, he has these nice doggy legs, or werewolf legs to be exact, and he has black claws on them. And again, really nicely sculpted. So that's pretty much it for the looks on this guy. Now, let me show you the articulation on this figure. Okay, so I took him off of the stand, and now let's see. So you can move his head to the sides, although the bandana, it's kind of limiting the articulation. You have to be careful with that a little bit. And it's actually like a double joint, because you can move it from here and from up here too, like that, you can see. One thing that I am kind of missing on this figure is that you can't open his mouth. I think that would have been much, much cooler if you would, if you could, but you know, that's okay. He has movement in his upper body, although mine kind of, as you can see, pops back, so not sure if that's how it's supposed to be, or mine is just, something's like bugging him, I don't know. And no, you cannot move it from down here, only just the upper part of the body. Now you can of course move the arms up and down and to the sides too, like that. He has movement on the upper arm, and he has a double joint in the elbow, just like that. So pretty cool. You can of course move his wrist. You can turn it all around and up and down, so it's on a ball joint. And of course you can move his leg to the sides too, and it goes pretty far out, honestly, so it's pretty cool. And there's also a double joint in the knee, so it can go back about this far, which is pretty cool. And you can also move the feet to the sides, up and down, pivot it around a bit, and you can move the feet this way too, but just only up and down. So yeah, pretty nicely articulated figure. And let me just put this in here, and just like that. So that's how he looks. So that's about it for this review of the Fortnite Dire Wolf or Werewolf figurine. If you like my review, please give me a thumbs up and comment down below what do you think of this figurine. Or if you can't comment, I'm not sure if I'm going to turn off the comments for this video, because Fortnite is pretty popular with kids nowadays. You can actually go ahead and comment on my Facebook page at this video, and you can go ahead and like the Facebook page too. The link will appear down below here, and yeah, you can state your opinion over there. What do you think of the figurine, or if you play the game, how is he in the game? I mean, he is pretty much a skin, if I'm correct, in the game, but if you played with this skin, how do you like it, what do you think of it, and whatever you want. And also, if you like my review, then don't forget to subscribe if you want to see more toy and doll reviews and action figure reviews like this. Thank you so much for watching, guys. Bye.